The real reason why Fast and Loud ended. For 8 years on air, the Texas-based Gas Monkey Garage and the reality show filmed by them has been famed for its on-screen drama. But what was shown to the audience was less than half the story. If you watch reality shows, then you must know this, that most automotive reality shows center themselves around a charismatic host, and Fast and Loud is no different, as it followed the similar strategy. The show's protagonist-come-host, Richard Rawlings, was a prolific businessman and self-proclaimed petrol-sexual. But Rawlings was often the source of many of the show's issues. So why was Fast and Loud canceled? And what did Rawlings have to do with the reason behind its cancellation? Stay with us until the end of the video to find out the real reason why Fast and Loud ended. And let's get started. Fast and Loud initially aired on Discovery Channel in June 2012. It was a reality television show on Discovery Channel that chronicled the activities of the team led by Rawlings at Gas Monkey Garage in Dallas. The show highlighted rundown vehicles that the team transformed into profit-generating cars. The show also featured two mechanical geniuses, Rawlings and Aaron Kaufman, as they scoured the remote reaches of Texas and beyond. The team explored the back roads, looking for that one special ride to restore in barns, swap meetings, and open fields. They always had at least one major customization job going on in their garage. The challenge, though, was in selecting the appropriate vehicle. However, after 8 successful years and 16 seasons, Rawlings gave bad news to its viewers and said that there would be no more of the episodes, and the series won't be back for season 17. So why was the show canceled? When the podcast host Rogan asked about his show, he revealed he has exited the Discovery Network and is now a free agent. But what actually happened? Let's dig a little deeper and find out more. Majority of us are familiar with Richard Rawlings being the host of Fast and Loud, but he is one of the most charismatic automotive personalities in the world. While he is perhaps most famous for hosting the show, he is also well known for the Gas Monkey Garage, which has a YouTube channel of the same name. Apart from this, he has been in various television commercials for the Dodge promoting their vehicles. So even if you think he is brash and loud, the job he and his team did on car restorations is second to none. The cancellation of the show was revealed when Rawlings was a guest on the Joe Rogan Experience in December 2020, on episode 1578 to be precise. During the show, Rogan asked Rawlings about what happened to the show. Rawlings straightforwardly said that the show was no more. He also revealed that he had left Discovery and that he was a free agent. At the same time, Rawlings was happy to announce that he had plenty of cool things lined up for the future. However, Rawlings also revealed that it was pretty difficult for him to decide about quitting the show, but he had always wanted to expand and grow further, so it was the perfect time for him to act on his thoughts for the future. But we can't really argue that Fast and Loud hadn't had a good run, and with 300-ish episodes, it had done very well and made Rawlings a household name in the United States and around the world. Talking about the problems, we can say that on and off screen, Rawlings was never far from controversy. Throughout the show's history, he had many disputes with some of his staff, and usually whenever an employee would run into an argument with Rawlings, they would soon find themselves run out of the garage. This happened quite a few times. On the other hand, Rawlings was struggling with his second marriage off-screen, as his 10-year partnership with Suzanne Margulies began to ruin, and while he was under great pressure managing his professional commitments, the two split. Fortunately, both of them were able to overcome their differences and remarried in 2015. So of course, all good things must come to an end. And back in 2020, when Rawlings announced that the famous Fast and Loud show was ending, it naturally came as a bit of a shock to many of his fans and fans of the show. The Discovery Channel TV show, starting on June 6, 2012 and ending on June 8, 2020, has nearly run for a decade. So, how did fans react to the news? It's pretty obvious that many Fast and Loud viewers were disappointed hearing about the cancellation of the show. One of the viewers took to Twitter and said, "Two of my favorites. I listened on my ride home and have to say, I'm sad to hear the news. Fast and Loud is one of my favorite shows. Thanks for 8 awesome years. Looking forward to what the future has for you and Gas Monkey Garage." In his response, Richard tweeted back, "Not the end, just a new chapter in @GasMonkeyGarage's book. Just you wait till you see what I have planned next. However, these were not the only disasters Rawlings had to face during his time as the star of Fast and Loud. And like many business moguls, Rawlings ventured into the hospitality industry by opening the Gas Monkey Bar and Grill, which also faced a lot of controversies, just like his show. Most notably, following a sting operation, it was revealed that they were replacing premium liquor with subpar substitutions, which created a lot of problems for him. Now it seems like Rawlings has left a lot of these things behind, and he is on a new journey to find success for himself. So can we expect the show to come back in the future? Well, back then, Rawlings spoke about what the future might hold for him. And one thing that he revealed at the time was that he wanted to work on was a podcast for himself. And no one in his world was really doing one at the time. He has, of course, appeared on quite a few podcasts since then. And it was an ambition of Rawlings for years. Rawlings said that social media didn't really fall into that, as it wasn't as big a thing in 2012 as it is now in 2022. Adding to this, Rogan spoke of a time when a potential employer wanted to control his social media, which was a hard no for him. Basically, Rawlings did not have the chance to post his own things while he was working on Discovery, as he was exclusively signed up to the channel. In addition, as part of his contract, there was a clause that essentially said that he couldn't say bad things about Discovery during his contract. That would in fact see him incur up to a $25,000 fine if he'd done so. And naturally, no one wants to pay that much if things are not good between yourself and your employing studio. We believe this is one of the major reasons why Rawlings actually quit, because he did not anyone controlling his freedom. So what is Rawlings doing now? Now that Rawlings has started his new journey, his on-screen style has evolved. He has started a podcast titled Monkey Trap, which is aimed to entertain his millions of admirers on Facebook, Instagram, and elsewhere. Fans can find it on YouTube. The move from Discovery to more focus on YouTube and various automotive ventures was a big switch for Rawlings. It is something he seems to be relishing with the extra freedom, because it did sound like it was frustrating with Discovery at times, as it took him 5 years, for example, to do a crossover with the legendary Chip Foose. And Discovery thought they were geniuses that the episode in the end did so well. Rawlings, though, has done very well since leaving the channel, and his content is some of the best there is. Adding to this, Rawlings also unveiled a $500,000 food truck with considerable curb appeal in Dallas recently. The 42-foot-long mobile kitchen vehicle is exclusively designed by Cameron Davies, CEO of San Antonio vehicle manufacturing company Cruising Kitchens. The food truck on steroids has a daily capacity to feed 10,000 people and will also feature t-shirt cannons. According to February 2021 reports, Rawlings intends to park the vehicle at the Monkey Yard, which is in the backyard of Gas Monkey Garage at 2330 Merrill Road in Dallas. Fans of Gas Monkey could enjoy the personalized menu created by the Discovery reality star that would include burgers, pizza, and tacos. Furthermore, as the Gas Monkey food truck was constructed, the video teams documented each stage with precision to entertain the fans, and the footage can be found on Rawlings' YouTube channel. So it seems like Rawlings made the best decision of his life when he canceled Fast and Loud, and he is pretty much happy in his current life of pure joy and freedom. That's all for today. If you are interested in our channel, have a look at this video. Thank you for watching, and make sure to subscribe.